random art tips and rambles with Rafi.
Hola, you amazing artist. It's Rafi.
And Klee.
And today we are going to talk about pricing artwork.
Oh,
yeah.
Interesting.
So you and I just had a conversation about pricing your artwork and feeling like insecure about your pricing.
Yeah, I think no matter how long you go about it, there's always some question about whether you're being fair to the market and fair to yourself and whether it's reasonable to other people, no matter how much experience you have with it.
I think it's interesting that we had the conversation that we had this morning because on Discord, a lot of the patrons that we have on Patreon were talking about pricing. One of our patrons was following another artist that was on YouTube. This artist is pretty famous and had like a TV show and stuff like that. And he was quoted as saying that you should never, ever, ever price under $2 a square inch, right? So she contacted him with her artwork and showed him, and he went against what he said. He said, well, you should be charging 50 cents a square inch. What was interesting to me was that in the first place, he said, no artist should be charging less than $2 a square inch. Like, this is some kind of rule that's set in stone in the art world.
Yeah, and then the Lord said, no painting shall sell.
Yeah. And then somebody approaches him and is like, well, how much should I sell mine? He's like, well, forget everything that I just said and charge $2 a square or 50 cents a square inch.
That's pretty offensive.
I know that she took that a little bit personally, like, well, what the hell? What do you mean by that? And the truth of the matter is that there are all kinds of formulas for pricing your artwork, pricing your jewelry, pricing whatever it is that you're pricing. And if you go on the internet and you're looking at pricing across the board, you'll see some pieces that are very similar that are very underpriced, and you'll see some pieces that are very similar that are very overpriced.
Yes, and this is rampant in the jewelry category.
Yeah, well, it's rampant in the jewelry category, but it's rampant in the art category as well.
Yeah.
You could get a 3-foot by 4-foot abstract painting on Etsy for $250, which is extremely lowballing the price, and you could get the same piece on Etsy for about $5,000. One of the questions that I get the most here is like, well, how do you price your stuff? And obviously we did the video on pricing your artwork where I talk about overhead and all that stuff and the different things that go into pricing your artwork and also how I do it, you know, per square inch.
Yeah.
And that when you raise your prices, that it should be organic. You know, the more demand you have, the higher your prices go. But ultimately, the most important thing that I talk about is using your gut for pricing.
Yeah, definitely. So I have a formula, as most everyone knows, because we've talked about this. I have a formula for pricing my work, but I've learned to be willing to tweak that number up or down depending on how I feel about it. So if my formula spits out a number and I'm like, that's slightly uncomfortable, but I can get on board with that, then great. And if it spits out a number and I'm like, that number makes me want to throw up in my mouth a little, then I know I need to adjust it. Or it spits out a number and I'm like, that's not fair to me for that amount of work, then I need to tweak it up. And really, like, your gut feeling is important, but I also think it's important to have at least some kind of foundation to work from so that you feel like you're comfortable. I think the most important thing is you get yourself to a place where you feel comfortable about how you're pricing your work.
Yeah, most definitely, because I mean, really when it comes down to it, so I do the square inch and I have different pricing for different square inch depending on the size of the piece. And I do that just to give me a baseline of what it is that I would charge. But there are so many factors that go into a piece, like how much time did I spend on it? How difficult was it for me to create that piece? What is it that I put into this piece that I haven't put into any others, or did I do less work on this piece? Essentially, what it always comes down to is I get a baseline of what the price is going to be, and then I make sure that I am both fair to myself and fair to the person that is buying the piece.
Mm-hmm.
Because I love and respect the people that collect my art. So I always want to make sure that they get a really good price and that I get paid for the work that I put into there. There is a fairness that happens, and that price has gone up little by little organically as the demand has grown and I've become more busy. and, you know, where I can't keep up with the work. So mm-hmm. unless I'm getting paid for it, I don't feel like it's fair to me. There's this fine balance that happens between being fair to yourself, most importantly, but also being very fair to the person that's going to collect your work.
Yeah. Now, here's the thing. This is a really abstract concept. Fair to somebody could mean $50,000, and fair to somebody else could mean $50.
Yeah, you know? But I don't – the thing is, when I'm being fair to somebody else, I don't care what their concept of fairness is. I'm only concerned with my concept of fairness because I'm the one that's pricing the piece.
Yeah, I guess what I'm saying is when you're first starting out and you have a limitless financial ballpark to work within, like, where's your starting point?
Yeah, and that's where the baseline comes in with the calculation. Yeah. So when I first started, I was pricing my pieces at about 36 cents an inch because I had no collectors. Nobody was looking for my art. There was no demand for my work. So that to me was a good price. Not only that, but I was super nervous about putting my artwork out there and very insecure about pricing. So I did about 36 cents a square inch. Then eventually, as the demand started to grow, I think I went up to like 45 cents a square inch. Several years later, as that started to grow, I went up to 75 cents a square inch. And now I'm in the ballpark of anywhere between $85 to $1.25 a square inch, depending on the size and the work that goes into the piece. Mm-hmm. Now, that's not very expensive when it comes to art, but it is a price where I feel comfortable at and I feel is fair for the person that's collecting my work and fair to me. Now, that also has the opportunity to keep growing in price as my demand starts to grow as well. And I think that that's where a lot of people get confused. Like right out of the ballpark, they go into pricing something really high because that's what they see that it's worth on the market. But the pricing of the work all depends on what the demand is for the work. So if you're just starting out and you've never shown your art out there, you have to build a following.
Absolutely.
And the best way to build the following is to price accordingly. So, you know, don't price yourself so low that it's not fair to you. But
don't price yourself out of the market.
Yeah,
either.
Don't price yourself out of the market because nobody knows who you are.
Yeah. And now there's a fine line between pricing yourself comfortably within your market and then comparing yourself to other people, which you really don't want to do because everyone's all over the place.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you can't – you shouldn't be comparing yourself to other people to begin with when it comes to your art, and B – when it comes to pricing, everybody is across the board. Everybody has a reason to justify why they price their pieces, whatever prices it is that they price their pieces, whether it is lowballing the market or overselling the market.
Yeah, and you're going to get all kinds of mixed responses from customers, too. I can't count the number of times I've been told that my jewelry is not priced high enough and that my jewelry is too expensive.
Yeah.
So it doesn't really matter as far as that's concerned. It matters that I feel good about my pricing. Now, you price per square inch mostly.
Yeah.
And I am using a formula that's cost of materials and mostly my time, an hourly rate that I've determined is comfortable.
Yeah.
Something that I've been talking with my fellow artists about is your time.
Right.
And it seems to me that a lot of artists are not compensating themselves for the time because they don't think that they can sell a piece for what it's worth based on how much time they've invested in it. One of my fellow artists I was talking to, when we broke down how she was pricing her work, we realized she's paying herself about 35 cents an hour for what she's doing.
Right, which is definitely not worth it.
No.
To put that much time into a piece.
And she doesn't believe that she can charge more than that and sell a piece.
See, a lot of this, like what you and I were talking about, goes back to a feeling of self-worth.
Yeah.
You know, if we start peeling back the layers of the onion, underneath the whole pricing dilemma is the mask of, like, I'm a charlatan, you know, I'm an imposter, the imposter syndrome. I don't deserve those prices.
Right.
My self-worth is what's underneath all of that.
It is a question of self-worth.
It is, because, you know, and a lot of people try to target this from on the surface, where they're talking about, well, what's the formula? Let me look up formulas. You could look up formulas on the internet on how to price your art or how to price your jewelry, and there's all kinds of formulas out there.
Oh, definitely.
And really what it comes down to is really getting a sense of your time, which is absolutely finite.
Yeah.
The one thing that we all have in common is that at some point we are going to run out of time, and your time is worth something.
Absolutely. And that's why it's mind-boggling to me that time seems to be the throwaway number for a lot of artists. Oh, yeah, it did take me 5 days to make, but, you know, I can't really charge for that.
Yeah. Yeah. And the reason they can't charge for it is because they're more concerned about what other people's perception is going to be about the price. And like you said earlier, I've had people that have walked into my booth and said, oh, my God, your artwork is so so cheap. Like, why is it so underpriced? It should be more expensive. I can't believe that you're only charging that much. And then I've had people walk into the booth and look at those same pieces and say, like, oh, your artwork's way too expensive. So, like, if you're going by what other people's opinions are going to be, you're going to drive yourself crazy.
Yeah.
Because at some points, you're going to feel like you're charging too much or you're not charging enough, and you're going to go back and forth and go crazy about that.
Absolutely. Even almost a decade into this, I still am affected sometimes if someone's like, your jewelry's not worth that.
Well, absolutely. And I mean, and you're going to get those comments, and you have to be confident enough in your own pricing, knowing that you are being fair to yourself and that you're being fair to other people. It doesn't mean that you're being fair to that person that says that everything is too expensive because they're super cheap. It just means that that person, your jewelry is not for them, or your artwork is not for them.
Yeah, because they don't see the value.
They don't see the value in it. And that's the thing. Like, everybody has a different perception. Not everybody is going to like the style of my art. Not everybody is going to like the price. Not everyone is going to like the colors that I use. Everybody has a different opinion about stuff, and they buy things according to what that opinion is. And pricing is no different. It's the same thing that we ran into with the Etsy thing with free shipping. And I've gotten contacted by people that tell me, like, yeah, of course, I don't expect to pay free shipping. And then there are other people that are like, I always expect free shipping. Everybody has a different opinion on stuff based on who they are and the way that they see the world.
Yeah.
And pricing is no different. And that's why pricing is such a subjective thing, that it makes it very confusing for somebody that is starting out.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, what you have to figure out is that pricing has to be fair for you. Whatever formula it is that you decide to use, I do square inch, but I also do hourly on some projects. Any projects where I'm going to spend a lot of time on that project and it's going to be very tedious, like, mm-hmm, I'm going to spend a lot of time and it's going to be tedious, I make sure that I charge hourly for that project, because I want to be working on this piece and feel like it's worth it to me financially to be sitting there.
Yeah, otherwise you don't want to be putting resentful, I'm not getting my fair share out of this energy into a piece.
And I mean, really, that's what it comes down to with pricing. You want to make sure that you charge enough so that when you sell the piece, you are excited about selling the piece. You are happy that that person bought that piece for that much, not, this person got such a good deal and they don't even realize it. And, you know, feeling that sense of resentment, like, you put all this work into this piece and you only got $40 out of it.
Right.
You know, and you walk away from that sale and you don't feel good. And that's the thing. You want to feel good when you walk away from a sale. You want to feel good, like, A, I'm very much appreciated for the stuff that I created. And B, I very much appreciate that person for purchasing it at that price. Not, I'm not appreciated for what I create, or be like, yeah, I made some money off that guy. You know, like, yeah, you want to be fair to yourself and you want to be fair to the other person. And really, when it comes down to it, only you can decide what that price is.
Yeah.
If you are overpricing something, then you are trying to compensate your feelings of self-worth. If you're overpricing something where you're completely uncomfortable with the price because it is so expensive, then you are trying to make up for the fact that you don't feel worth it. You're trying to show people that, yeah, my artwork is expensive, even though you haven't sold any. Basically, it comes down to somebody's like, how much is that piece? And you'd be like, oh, that one's $1,000? You know, like, there's no confidence there. Whereas you want your confidence behind your price to be wrapped around your self-worth, but be separate from it.
Yeah.
You know, you are worthy as an artist. Your price is whatever it is that you decide to put on the piece. If somebody thinks that it's too expensive, that should have no impact on your own sense of worth.
And that's why something you said early in the podcast really makes sense to me. When I first started selling my work, it was pretty cheap.
Yeah.
Like, my prices were pretty low, and they grew organically over time as I became more of a master of my craft, and also as the demand grew. And because it grew organically, it was more of a comfortable process. I wouldn't say it was a comfortable process, but it was more comfortable than just trying to pick a random number or yeah. formula.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I started off small, built up a following for my work, and the prices did grow organically. If you're starting with no idea at all, and maybe if you're starting with no or very little self-worth because you haven't experienced putting your artwork out there or you're questioning yourself, pick a formula.
Yeah.
Try it out and see how you feel about it.
When I very first started, I had no idea what I was going to price my stuff. I had some pieces that were 16 by 20. That were on poster board, and I had some pieces that were on canvas. And essentially, I was just showing my stuff for the first time. I didn't think that anybody would buy any of the things that I created. And so I had 16 by 20s, and I priced those at $40 because that's what I figured I should price them at. The stuff that was done on poster board, I priced at about $15 to $20. And then I had these little things that were priced at like $10, and I put them out there. And was completely blown away the first time that somebody bought one of my $40 pieces. Mm-hmm. And was completely blown away then when somebody bought the $10 piece. And, you know, from there, I just kind of priced things at that price for the first month or so. And then as things started to sell a lot more, I started to realize like, oh man, it's a pain in the ass to try and keep up with the demand. So then I raised the price by $10, and then I raised the price by $20 eventually after that. And then after that was when I came up with my formula of per square inch. Mm-hmm. And the thing is that start from where you are and price things in a way, you know, when you're getting started, don't get bogged down by trying to figure out a formula. Obviously, if you're pricing something that has expensive materials in it, you want to take that cost in there and you want to take your overhead in there. But also, if you're not sure about that, that is all stuff that you can learn as you go. Just price it at something that you're comfortable with, that you are comfortable telling somebody what that price is going to be, and then go from there. You could always raise your prices eventually as you're going, and you will raise your prices. It's just being comfortable with the price that you put out there. That's what ultimately matters, because you have to be comfortable with yourself. A lot of us have, like I said earlier, our self-worth tied into the price of the artwork, and that's not the way that it should be.
It's dangerous territory.
It is very dangerous territory, because the moment that somebody says that your work is overpriced,
that means you're not worth it.
Yeah, you take it as a personal attack.
Yeah.
You know, and vice versa. If they say, oh, this is totally underpriced, like this should be more expensive, then all of a sudden you feel really good about yourself.
Yeah.
And your self-worth should not be wrapped up in what you are pricing your work. Your work should be priced at something that you feel is fair, but it has nothing to do with your value of yourself. You know what I mean?
And oh, absolutely.
And because we're dealing with money, it is easy to get those two mixed up.
Yeah. It can be a real emotional roller coaster.
Yeah, exactly. Which is why people have such a difficult time in pricing their work.
That's why people like me, someone like me, it helps me to have a formula to work off of, a foundation to stand on.
Yeah.
And for crying out loud, your time investment is a big factor.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do not undervalue your time.
Yeah.
You don't need to charge exorbitant prices you're uncomfortable with, but don't go the bare minimum either. Don't pay yourself 35 cents an hour.
No, no way. No way. You want to make sure that you are, like I said, fair to yourself. You have to walk away from the transaction feeling good.
Yeah.
That's what it means to be fair to yourself. That you walk away from the transaction feeling good. That you don't feel like you've undersold yourself and you don't feel like you've scammed somebody out of money. You want to feel good. And don't worry about where that pricing is set, you know, or whether or not it's too high or too low, just as long as you feel good about it, because you could grow that organically. You have to start with where you are.
Yeah.
That's what matters.
And unfortunately, there's no more specific answers that we can cover here, because this is going to vary by geographic location, availability of places to show your work, your general market, your general feelings about your work.
How long you've been selling your work, yeah. How many pieces you've sold before. I mean, there are so many factors in it. There is no one place to start. You know, I'm not going to be like that guy and be like, yeah, if you're pricing under $2, yeah, okay, that's great. If maybe you're in New York at some big festival, but if you're sitting in our town, in a small town at a flea market, there's no way that you're going to sell some work for $2 a square inch.
Likely not.
Especially if you don't feel like that's a fair price, because you're still working on your own self-esteem and your own confidence level.
Right. And I have found that to be the single most important factor in setting prices, is that you feel comfortable and confident. Whether you're posting them online or you have to tell someone to their face what the price is, that you feel good about it. I'll give you this to work off as a closing thought. When I started this and I quit the last job that I had, I knew I wanted to make at least as much or more as I was making at my job in order to feel like it was worth it. So my hourly rate was at least as much as I had been paid at my last job, and no less than that, and then covered my cost of materials.
Yeah.
And that's how I started out.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then it grew from there.
Yeah, and it grew from there. And basically, you know, and if anybody's curious about what the calculation is, we do have the video that's out there on how to price your work. Mm-hmm. And we cover overhead and hourly rate and all that stuff in there. But yeah, ultimately what it comes down to is it's easier to have a formula to work off of. But always just take a look at that price and go with your gut as far as what it is that you're comfortable with. And I would suggest that, you know, as far as like raising your prices, raise your prices just enough to make it slightly uncomfortable, but not too uncomfortable. You know what I mean? And don't worry about that, because that price will grow. I revisit my pricing at least once every 6 months. Just to make sure that I'm feeling good about where my prices are. So far, my prices have grown at least once a year when I do that, when I reevaluate my prices and look at where I'm at. Because my career has grown, my prices have grown with it. Not huge price jumps, but just enough to organically grow little by little.
I think that's a good point to make too. We do revisit our prices frequently, especially if you're in the jewelry category where metal prices are constantly changing. That's a whole other story for another time. But you have to revisit that. And the decisions you make right now are not written in stone forever.
No.
You could change them tomorrow. You could change them a month from now. So just try things and see how it goes.
Yeah, so hopefully you guys found that helpful as far as pricing. I know that I've gotten a lot of questions about pricing, and obviously this morning we were having the conversation about pricing, so I thought that this would be a great topic to sit and have a conversation about. Just to let you guys know, this week I will be going dark. I will be going airplane mode dark so that I could get my book finished. There will be this podcast, and of course we'll be still doing the live stream on Wednesday at 7 p.m.
Yes, indeed.
So you guys could hang out with us there. But other than that, I will be finishing up, finalizing my book this week. Which is super exciting and super terrifying at the same time. And we'll be posting about it next week, and everything will go back to our regularly scheduled programming next week.
Yes, indeed. So we will hopefully see you guys on the live stream, and you'll be getting updates from us.
I'll be updating you guys across the social media, on Instagram, on where I'm at with the book and all that stuff. But yeah, we should be back next week. And yeah, that's it.
Until then, happy creating.
Yeah, happy creating, you guys. And thank you so much for listening. You guys are absolutely amazing. I totally adore you. And if you like this podcast and you want to listen to more like this, you could obviously subscribe to our channel. And that's it. Say goodbye, Klee.
Good day, everyone.
Adios.